Mysterious radio signals have been detected from a distant galaxy. Welcome to Inform Overload. I'm your host, Johnny Rogers. And if you're new here, we find the most interesting news stories on the internet and we make them more entertaining. Scientists have reported in a news conference that they have spotted repeated blasts of radio signals coming from a distant galaxy deep in space. This is the second time that scientists have heard these kinds of repeated bursts of sound waves. This is a major breakthrough and also deepens this mystery, but also offers up a great opportunity to understand what is causing this. The initial radio bursts were believed to simply be exploding stars, but now many are speculating that it could be transmissions by aliens from a galaxy billions of light years away. The flashes of radio signals only last for about a millisecond, but are sent with the same energy that the sun takes 12 months to produce. The most thrilling thing about these repeated bursts is that scientists reported seeing it repeat 6 times from the same location. So far, they have recorded 60 radio bursts, but only one of them seems to be repeating itself. Ingrid Stairs, an astrophysicist at UBC, had this to say: "Until now, there was only one known repeating FRB. Knowing that there is another suggests that there could be more out there. And with more repeaters and more sources available for study, we may be able to understand these cosmic puzzles, where they're from and what causes them." And in 2 papers published in Nature, the researchers wrote, "Seeing 2 repeating signals probably means that 3 exists, and that humanity will probably find a substantial population of repeating signals. The fact that 2 sets of repeating bursts exist means that scientists can begin to distinguish them from single bursts and help them understand where they're coming from so that they can watch for more." In a 3-week period, the researchers spotted roughly 13 bursts, giving them a ton of data to hunt for the source. Some are claiming it could be a mysterious technology that alien civilizations are using to launch into space. Arun Naidu, a research team member at McGill University, said, "Whatever the source of these radio waves is, it's interesting to see how wide a range of frequencies it can produce. There are some models where intrinsically the source can't produce anything below a certain frequency. Of those 13 blasts that I mentioned, at least 7 of them were recorded at 400 megahertz, which is the lowest of any yet to be discovered. This suggests that even more could exist, but are just too low to be picked up." Tom Landecker, a member of the National Research Council of Canada, said, "We now know the sources can produce low frequency radio waves, and those low frequency waves can escape their environment, and are not too scattered to be detected by the time that they reach Earth. That tells us something about the environments and the sources. We haven't solved the problem, but it's several more pieces in the puzzle." I want to hear your thoughts on this story though. Do you think that the radio waves are coming from an alien technology, or could they be from stars exploding deep in the galaxy? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. With that, I want to move on to some of your featured comments from the video titled "Top Secret UFO Program Revealed in Project Blue Book." Julio says, "What if aliens believe in us and they have their own book where they write everything Americans did in space?" You know what? They probably do. If they exist, why not? Kazuma Yami says, "Blue Book sounds so cliche." Yeah, why not the Green Book or something? That would make more sense. And Moody says, "Hello, why do you have to yell, Johnny? Then you talk so fast, can't keep up and listen to that. Slow down and breathe, my friend. Man, oh man, that potato is going to burst and make mashed potatoes. If you don't like it, turn down your volume and set the speed to half."
There, I fixed it. I'ma do me.
Daniel Bradler says, "The UFO research program has never stopped. Do you know something that you're not telling us? Ladies and gentlemen, and potatoes, we have a secret insider in the chat." Dick Tracy says, "IO with no Charlotte is like driving a car with the gas light on." This is actually a perfect joke that deserves way more likes than it got. If you believe this, just do what you would do with a gaslight. Put some electrical tape over my face and ignore the noise. Thank you for watching Inform Overload. Hit that thumbs up button if you enjoyed this video. And if you're new here, don't forget to subscribe. Plus, if you want more videos like this one, just click that playlist on the screen. And if you find any new and exciting stories that you want us to cover, look for my Instagram in the description below. Send me a DM. From Inform Overload, I'm Johnny Rogers, and until next time, take care.